Hey crew, I've got the key to yet another Lamborghini Huracan STO. But this isn't just a regular STO, no, this is a VF Engineering hypercharged STO. It's a supercharger, they call it a hypercharger. And we are gonna take it for a drive, but first let's check out how it looks on the inside and outside. Now on the exterior, it is going to look just like the regular STO, except this one is in a wrap, so you've got this white on orange combination here. But like the standard STO, we have these massive NACA ducts in the single piece hood and fender unit. Prominent front splitter in carbon fiber. So much cooling. These aluminum alloy wheels. Large carbon ceramic brakes. Scalloped fenders. Gosh, these look cool. Carbon fiber roof scoop. Inlets down low, mid, and over the rear wheel arches, the louvered engine bay, and the shark fin splitting the difference. Now this one obviously says VF Engineering on the side, but their customer cars are not going to be quite as advertising of the additional power at the disposal. Down low, it's that three position rear wing taking over the whole frame here. And then they have, this is Nick Saran's car, hypercharge for the license plate. Center exit exhaust ports, the STO imprinted within the metal mesh, and the very large, very in charge carbon fiber diffuser. The wrap job would not be my personal choice, but the car looks just as menacing as the last STO. Let's go check out that interior. Opening up and looking inside, the very purpose-built cabin with the carbon fiber buckets wrapped in Alcantara with red accents. We have STO stitched on the seat backs, some exposed carbon fiber there, Lamborghini crest stitched on the headrests, all manual adjustments here. So you pull this lever to slide the seat forward or backward, pull this one to raise or lower the seat bottom, and then crank that knob for the back angle. The door panels are all in this matte carbon fiber. It's beautiful, but there's no armrest, there are no frills. You don't even have a door handle. You just have this red tab you pull. Door mirror adjustments are here, lock and unlock there. Sliding inside, not quite as gracefully as I would like. We're looking at a Alcantara wrapped flat bottom steering wheel with red contrast stitching and a red center marker. All your things are at a fingers reach away. So you've got your turn signal indicators are there and your wiper controls are there. Drive mode selections here. Then your huge paddles, tons of travel there. Digital instrument cluster changes a bit as you go through the drive modes here. Carbon fiber housing, all this Alcantara on the dashboard, more carbon fiber on the air vents, all these switches, this one for your left door window, right one, right door window, your nose lift system, traction control, hazards, and start stop. Then we've got an 8.4 inch touchscreen infotainment that works just fine. Then your start stop under the missile style launcher, pull back for reverse, park and manual mode, your e-brake, and then there's even carbon fiber on the center armrest. There's no console storage. In fact, the storage in this car is very minimal. Two USB ports, and we've got the fire extinguisher. Very important. I actually have headroom here too. So yes, I'm cozy and I'm ready for a drive. Let's take it. All right, let's fire it up. And we're gonna be following over to a very fun canyon. James in his Audi R8 V10, a pair of V10s for us here. Pull the right paddle to go into first gear. I'm going to lift up the nose to exit the VF Engineering driveway without any scraping mishaps. Well, it's probably gonna turn down the AC at some point. Not that it's gonna be louder than the V10 engine, but just to kill that white noise.
All right, so VF supercharged Huracan STO. You're taking a car with a 5.2 liter naturally aspirated V10 engine that makes 630 horsepower, and you're raising that to over 800 horsepower. I think Nick said on 91 octane, this is making like 830, 840 horsepower. If you're on 93 octane, you can make even more. Now, you might think like, all right, supercharger moving up from 630 to 840, that's a big gain, but it's not massive. Why not go for more? Well, it's only got 6.5 bar of boost that it's generating, and that is pretty conservative as superchargers go. Nick Saran, the founder and owner of VF Engineering, says the purpose of that is to make a reliable supercharged supercar. Something that is going to be for the long term, not doing any real damage to the car. And furthermore, something that is actually going to be usable. It is not going to scare you to drive the car. And at these low speeds, that's precisely what this car is. Also at these low speeds, I'm not hearing a ton of that supercharger whine. Let's see, as we pick up the speeds, what happens. Going into Trofeo, oh, there's a bit more. Yes, I can feel the difference. I can absolutely feel the difference. There's this effortlessness to the way it pulls mid-range. And the beauty of this style of supercharger system, the Roots style, or Roots or the Twin Scroll, both have this the way of elevating the torque curve so it stays linear the way that the car was manufactured. It's just, there's just more of it. And so even at low RPM, I'm gonna go into seventh gear. It just pulls so strongly, whereas I distinctly recall, just to try it out, in the standard STO, going into 7th gear at right around 2500 RPM at highway speeds, there's just nothing there. You have to drop it down gears. Here, more accessible performance in more environments. That's super appealing. That's ludicrous. The velocity is mind-bending. There's been the faintest hesitation, and that's likely due to the software tweaks that they have made. And I believe James was saying there's an additional software that they've added on top of that that comes with the supercharger system on this car here. And so there may still be some fiddling, and it doesn't happen every time, but every so often, the fourth to third downshift hesitates. That you will not find in the stock STO. But if you wait that extra fraction of a second to downshift and then accelerate, what you find is absurd levels of power. Just unbelievable. struggled to, before I got behind the wheel of this car, I struggled to envision enhancing that STO driving experience, because that car will by far and away go down as one of the most enticing, all-encompassingly fun driving experiences I've ever had. This, I'll say this, it doesn't transform the car, right? It doesn't become a different animal. It's still very much the STO, but it ups the ante, because we know, it's just something we know, that automakers are run by accountants. Lamborghini wouldn't give this to you. They give you an incredible car in the STO. Nick Saran and his team at VF know that, and they're not trying to mess with that recipe at all. Instead, they're just adding a few more chili flakes. They're making it just a little spicier. But speaking of spicy, let's get to some canyon driving. And as an introduction to the absurdity that awaits us, how about a 0-60 test? So I've got my race box all set up here. Just gonna hold my foot hard on the brake with traction control off. Cross mode and go. Oh, it was fighting so hard for traction. So hard for traction, and that is why we're only looking at a 3.5 second 0-60. These Bridgestone Potenzas were just overwhelmed. If the tires were super warm, which they were not, and if we were on the right surface, I have no doubt that based on the tenacity of that launch, we'd have had a 0-60 time of mid to low 2 seconds, which would have bested the stock STO's 2.6 seconds. Goodness, that was ferocious. Hesitation from the 4-3, but it's not all the time. However, all the time, I do have this incredible G-force pressing my face so hard against the headrest. This. It's not just how effortlessly does it deliver that power and the gains in a straight line, it's how does it change the driving dynamics. And we don't have a perfectly official quote from VF Engineering on how much weight is being added with the system. He was saying roughly, you know, based on the subtracting the components they take out, adding in the components they add, that made sense, it's kind of 100 horsepower or 100 pound difference. With a car like the STO, it's so focused on being light and not having too much weight transferring in corners, you gotta think, okay, an extra 100 pounds and position on top of the engine, so not as low down as possible, that may change something. And you know what? On a super technical, no long straightaway racetrack, perhaps you may lose fractions of a second. But on any big boy racetrack where you have a straightaway, you're gonna gain back so much time that it really isn't going to matter. And more importantly, this car still drives just as sweetly. The dynamics are just as precise. Those brakes are just as triumphant. The turn in is just as sharp, and the weight transfer is just as fluid. So, my friends, what are we dealing with here then? What is this car? What is this system? The VF Engineering STO supercharger and the component software are a way of not just having bragging rights. They're going to dyno this car, they'll know the official horsepower figure. It's not just the bragging rights to your other friends who happen to have STOs or other incredible supercars. It is an additional carefree dose of adrenaline for $40,000 over the, what, $333,000 to start for the STO. That's chump change to those who can afford this. And I say carefree because I want to reiterate that Nick Saran and his team have developed this system for longevity. They didn't go crazy with it. They didn't dial up the boost to some absurd level, give it 1,000 horsepower, hand over the keys to owners, let them kill themselves, but furthermore, kill the car in short order, not having upgraded any of the other components. No, they were very conservative because their goal is simply to heighten the STO driving experience for the long term. This is a bolt-on, fully reversible system so that if you go to sell the car, you can take off the supercharger and sell an STO that really hasn't been messed with. To be able to improve the performance, not mess with any of the beautiful baked-in Lamborghini goodness for an extra $40,000. Yes, we need some software tweaks to get that shifting just perfect, to have the transmission software just perfectly dialed in. But from a livability standpoint, this is every bit as good as the fully factory STO. Guys, I hope you've enjoyed this POV drive review. If you did, please like, comment, and share the video. Subscribe to the channel. Hit that bell to get notified. And I'll see you next time.